Hey guys, this is Futures of Blood here, and today we're going to be finishing off where I last left off of part one of What If Future Gohan Didn't Die. This is part two of What If Future Gohan Didn't Die. Where we last left off, Future Gohan and Trunks emerged from the Hyperbolic Time Chamber. Overall, were a lot stronger than the androids. Future Gohan and Future Trunks, their power levels are going to be in question right now. I'm going to tell you how powerful they are. They're going to be as strong as Goku and Trunks in the building movie. The reason I'm saying Goku is Goku was a lot stronger than Gohan in that movie, but I'm not too sure because I got this from Wikipedia. So I'm sorry if you guys don't feel like this is correct at all, but let me know if you guys want any opinions. Just let me know in the comments down below. But yeah, Gohan in his base form is about 50 million. Trunks in his base form is about 41 million. And the master for Gohan in his master SSJ form, yes, I forgot to mention that they do achieve grade 4 of Super Saiyan. Gohan's power level is about 2 billion and 600. While Future Trunks' power level is 2 billion and 50 million. They're still kind of away from each other, but at the same time, Gohan is stronger than Trunks. Of course, because Gohan's older, and yeah, yada yada yada. But the androids in this timeline are they're pretty much finished. This is again from Wikipedia. Future Android 17. Power level is about 380 million, while Future Android 18 is about a power level of 280 million. And yeah, the power levels are—they're gonna be destroyed at this point. And after they leave the lookout, they follow the dwindling key of dying people, and they arrive to see the androids destroying another city. The androids underestimate Trunks and Gohan again. They both go SSJ, and 18 goes to attack Trunks, but he easily counters, knocking him into a building. Gohan would throw a ki blast and pushing 17 into the air and grabs him by his leg, throws him into the ground, and does a one-handed Kamehameha, finishing him and destroying him in the process. While Gohan was dealing with 17, Trunks was finishing off 18 with an Insane Cut. While they celebrate, after 2 days after celebrating, they defeat the androids, and Gohan and Trunks start thinking about the fallen D warriors. And Gohan says, "I know the existence of New Namek, but I don't know the location." And then Bulma says, "I'm working on a time machine, and I'm thinking if we can help our past selves, it could create a butterfly effect and bring back the fallen D fighters." And the time machine, and she said that the time machine will take 2 months to finish. But they will only have one seat in the time machine. I know this is pointless, but yeah. But they told Bulma that they would find another way. They would find, not another way, but find a way around it. Sorry, guys. And yeah, after that, they just start training again. And Bulma said it would take about 1 week to finish it. Well, not 1 week, but 1 week to finish making the fuel for the time machine. So yeah, guys, this is part two. I'm sorry for the stuttering again. I'm still getting used to this. Please excuse my stuttering. And if you guys, please go subscribe to Hydro Kenzo because he helped me the most in this part because I needed a lot with scripting. And I'm still new to this. So yeah, guys, I'll see you guys in the next part. And also, please go subscribe. One more thing, please go subscribe to Hydro and Diamond Legend and GoHeezy for helping me again. And I'll see you guys in the next What If scenario. And thank you guys for the support. Please, if you can get this video to 5 likes again, that'd be great. And if you guys love this part, please hit for that. Hit the like button again. If you guys feel like you want to, if you enjoy it, then just do it. And I'll see you guys in the next What If scenario. Well, not What If scenario, but I'll see you guys in the next part. Peace.